Got one timber post in the ground, 6x6. It's filled with about 8 bags of cement. That post solid will be able to support our new iron gate that we're gonna be putting up right here. It's gonna be about 6 feet in width and about 6 feet tall. The only problem is we took out a post that was here and I'm gonna get rid of all this cement here. So you're looking at another hole that'll probably take about 10 bags. My legs and feet are sore. Life will never be what it was. My mind is shaking. Cause now my future is crashing down on me. Justice will never make this right. I need to run and stay out of sight. And the choice, it was me or them. Now for a lifetime I'm condemned. I have to forget my own set way of life. I'll go to prison or die by the knife. So got the wooden post set, got the hinges installed, routed out the wood for the hinges sitting there, and got the hinges welded to my tube steel. The 45 degree cut in the top and the bottom. Yes, sir. Well, that's it. Be back. Going to the store, take a break. So got the outside frame of the gate tack welded. Started on the hinge post, and then tack welded this one. Make sure you have a level. And we tack welded this one straight up, and then tack welded the one on top last. So it's gonna be a big gate. Leave that something underneath it so it doesn't drop when you're building it. Big gap like this. Start off on a corner or something. Build your bead up. See how I build my bead up? Then once I build my bead up, it's metal that got hot and cold, so it's a lot stronger than this metal. So I'm gonna work my weld off of that bead. Work my way up. Big gap to fill, just start a bead at the top or bottom, let it cool down, and work your bead off of that bead. But real quick, the way we built it is started here, welded this onto the hinges, welded the bottom brace, but you notice we got this 2x4 right here. It goes all the way across over here. That's to ensure that when you're welding,
that your frame doesn't tweak on you when you're applying heat, because you can feel this thing is hot. When you apply a lot of heat, the metal works. So this and this down here is to prevent it from warping out of place when you're welding. So keep that in mind. Alright, next thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna unhook the gate. We're gonna open the gate and see how it swings. Get all the hot shit.
Alright, metalwork's done. Metalwork is done. All welded up. I'm going to paint it and install the wood. I'm gonna paint the post too, timbers. So the metalwork's done. The primer and paint is done, flat black. The poles, touch them up with some poly, mahogany color, timbers. Last and final step, put pickets in the center, and then button up this chain link to the post. This is also a fence that we just built right before the gate build, right there. It's the back view, using three rails, post set every 8 feet. See how straight that is? Straight, and here's the front view, 6 foot. That side too. And that's what we're working on last but not least. All right, all done. Here it is. Look how she closes. The wind closes it, but there it is. There it is. All done. Timber wood posts. 2-inch square tube metal frame with metal pickets. Cedar sitting in the middle. 6x6 timbers. Look at that. Real nice. Reach around pool latch. I like it, sir.
I love it.
He doesn't like it. He loves it, he said.
I love it.
Alright. It is. And the fence too is all buttoned up too. Here and then over here. You want to look at that. Go.